local government has always been keen to support the arts and creativity. In Sheffield, they prefer to put their money where their mouth is, cut the red tape. And they're cutting it. Red Tape Studios.
Kevin from the Compsat Angels rang up one day and said, I know you're looking for a studio, come and talk to the council. And the council promised us a half grant. I talked to the guy that started the idea, and he talked to me about having a music publishing business, which just seemed completely odd to me. I said, why do you want to do that? And he said, because I'm sick of seeing kids ripped off. I thought, that's brilliant. It's so firmly embedded now that people are exploited in this business that it's amazing that someone would come along and not try and exploit people. We sort of started out as a very independent sort of setup, did everything ourselves, and slowly turned into music industry puppets, other people writing most of the songs on records, you know, and doing what we're told. I think we're going back in the other direction. I still love synthesizers for the Human League. That was what we were about, and our only problem really was doing it too successfully for a while, that it took the challenge away. But in theory, the Human League only use vocals recorded with microphone. Everything else is sort of theoretical till it reaches the speakers. It's worked out in the computer somewhere. We're trying to record another LP and really start back in the direction that we came from. My aim's always hits, really. All I ever wanted was like top 10 records, preferably in America.